We've come up with an initial design for our photo sharing application database. And in the last video, we really established that there's some kind of relationship or link between records in these different tables. So in this video, we're going to start to discuss how we can somehow reflect a relationship between different records that are stored in our database. To help you understand what is going on here, I first want to show you just this screenshot once again. So in the screenshot, we saw that we are looking at a profile page for a very particular user. And it looks like this user, called Instagram, had posted some number of photos. So we would say that these are photos that are somehow related or owned by this very particular user. So inside of our database, we need to set up some kind of relationship. We need some data somewhere that says these different photos belong to this user. To model this in our database, we're going to first learn about four different kinds of relationships. There are four different kinds of ways of relating together different kinds of records. After we understand some terminology around these four different kinds of relationships, we'll then discuss how we actually implement each of these inside of our database. And then, of course, we'll go through some examples as well. Okay, so let's take a look at a diagram and really understand the relationship between a user and photos, and then how we might describe that in the world of SQL. Okay, so in this diagram, we've got a user called Instagram here on the left-hand side, and this user owns many different photos. This user is somehow tied to these photos. We would refer to this kind of relationship as a one-to-many relationship. This is the first kind of relationship that we're going to look at out of four different kinds. So this is relationship type number one, a one-to-many relationship. We refer to this as a one-to-many relationship because one user has many photos that are tied to them. So besides calling this a one-to-many relationship, in practical language, like everyday language, as you're talking to another engineer, to refer to this relationship, rather than saying one-to-many, you might instead say a user has many photos. Anytime you see the words has many, that is a sign of a one-to-many relationship. Let's take a look at another kind of relationship that's really just the same one, just kind of the opposite. So if we look at this relationship from the perspective of a photo, then we might say that a bunch of different photos belong to one user, or a single photo has one user. We would refer to this as a many-to-one relationship. So many different photos belong to one single user. And I want you to notice right away that out of these first two relationships we've looked at, one-to-many and many-to-one, they're the exact opposite of each other. And it really just depends upon which perspective you are looking at this relationship from. So if you're looking at this from the perspective of a user, it is a one-to-many relationship. If you're looking at it from the perspective of a photo, it is a many-to-one. So anytime you see one-to-many or many-to-one, you can kind of flip that relationship on its head, and the opposite will still be true. Now, I know this initial idea might be a little bit confusing, so let's take a look at a couple more examples and really understand what is going on with a one-to-many and a many-to-one. All right, so back here, another screenshot very quickly. So on this page, remember, we had the ability for users to post comments to a single photo. Let's try to imagine how we might represent this relationship and how we might describe it with the terms one-to-many and many-to-one. Okay, quick diagram here. There we go. So in this case, we have a photo, and a photo can have many different comments tied to it. So notice that term I just used, a photo has many comments. That is a sign of a one-to-many relationship from the perspective of the photo. And again, we can flip this relationship on its head and consider it from the perspective of a comment. So many different comments belong to one photo, or we might say a comment has one photo. And again, we would refer to this as a many-to-one relationship. Let's take a look at a couple more examples very quickly. All right, so we've got boat and crew member, schools and students, companies and employees. These are all examples of one-to-many or many-to-one relationships. And again, it just depends upon the perspective that you're viewing the relationship from. We would say that a boat has many crew members, a school has many students enrolled, and a company has many employees. We could take a look at the opposite direction, and we would say that a crew member has one boat. A crew member in general is only stationed on one boat at a time, and it is unlikely that they're going to be shipped around to different boats. Likewise, a student, in general, just belongs to one school. Now, I'm sure you might know someone who attended two different schools at the same time, but we're just going to kind of generalize this for right now and say that a student has one school. They are only enrolled to one single school at a time. Likewise, I'm sure you might know someone who has multiple different jobs. Totally possible. Many people in the world have many jobs. They are employed by many different companies, but we can kind of generalize this for right now and say that an employee has one company. They are employed by a single company at a time. So from the left-hand side, going to the right, we would say it's a one-to-many, one-to-many, one-to-many. And then going from the right to the left, we would say that it's a many-to-one, many-to-one, many-to-one. Okay, so one-to-many and many-to-one are the first two kinds of relationships that we are going to inspect. And for each of these, the kind of telltale sign are the words has many and has one. Anytime you kind of want to refer to relationship using the terms has many or has one, that's always a sign that you have a one-to-many or a many-to-one relationship. So at this point, we're really just at the stage of describing these different relationships and kind of thinking about real-world scenarios of each of them. But we are going to eventually have to understand how to implement these relationships in data as well. So in the next video, we're going to examine two other kinds of relationships very quickly, and then right after that, we're going to figure out how we can somehow relate different records inside of our database using a one-to-many or many-to-one kind of relationship. So quick pause, two other relationships in the next video.